Hey guys, it's Alicia, aka. Why are you growling? Aka La Hapawana, and welcome to another comic review. I am super stoked for today's review. It's gonna be over Bombshells United, number 1 and 2. There's a lot of reasons why I suddenly felt compelled. Mila,
stop!
Why I felt compelled to do a review over these two. I'm gonna go ahead and list those for you really quickly. 1. Is the presence of different types of female superheroes that do not directly resemble that of Wonder Woman. 2. Overarching themes that question the subjectivity of morality. 3. Literary elements of historical fiction. And 4. Philosophy of human condition and how it bridges the gap between normal people and superheroes. The four items that I just mentioned are kind of like the most broad elemental themes of Bombshells United, so I just want to touch on those each just a little bit. The presence of so many female superheroes that are nothing like Wonder Woman is incredible. And that's not a criticism of Wonder Woman whatsoever, more than it is a compliment of inclusion. The first page of the first, I always want to call them episodes, like it's Star Wars or something, of the first book, it literally lists 12 different female superheroes that are involved within Bombshells. So I don't know about anyone else, but when I open a comic and I'm like, oh cool, you know, it's got Wonder Woman on the cover, and I read the first page and it starts talking about all of these other women, I'm getting really excited. And I need to emphasize that it doesn't make me excited because of only the fact that they're females. It makes me excited because now that's 12 new female characters that hopefully, you know, all can differentiate from one another. I know that in previous videos I have expressed criticism of a lot of female superheroes having the same background, and to me, there just hasn't been huge differentiation between one female superhero to the next. If you read the new Batgirl, if you read the new Miss Marvel, if you read the new Spider-Gwen, they all start in the same place and they all kind of end in the same place where, you know, they're starting out as a really naive girl who maybe is having some kind of identity issue, so it's more like a personal growth story, and then you throw in superpowers into the mix and it's just like, what's happening? You know, when you're looking at male superheroes, there's clear delineation between who they are, not just because of their name and their costumes, but because of their personalities. Batman is super different than Superman. The Joker is super different than Lex Luthor. Wolverine is way different than Ant-Man. And again, it's not because of who they are as superheroes, but who they are as individuals. So anyway, I got really interested. I was automatically like, okay, this is cool. So as I started reading, you know, I was just internally like, man, I really hope that there's clear delineation between these characters and that they establish really good identities for each individual female. And they did! So that made me really happy. I know I'm only 2 books in, but I'm really looking forward to that as it progresses. To touch on my second point, I absolutely love that in so many instances of these comics, they have touched on dilemmas of moral subjectivism. I am like moral subjectivism, objectivism queen. So like whenever I see things like this, I love it because I think that socially, you know, there's a lot of pressure to just follow the norms of morality. But rarely do we ever get instances like these two comics where it's kind of in your face, wow, I'm actually questioning, is this form of morality actually a good thing? Or is this form of morality actually a bad thing? And, you know, this is real life stuff. And, you know, I've seen this theme in other comics. Name any Alan Moore comic book and, you know, that's kind of like an overarching theme. But I haven't really seen it in more popular titles, if that makes sense. So it's always been kind of like one of those really niche, like, one of those niche comic themes where it's like, okay, this is clearly a very dark comic book. It's gonna have some really like deep moral questions to it, kind of thing. But when you're reading things like Bombshells, they're throwing these things at you kind of in passing. So like, it's relatively lighthearted for what it is. But when they start having dialogue about like, you know, why are you doing it like this? And, oh, I'm doing it to protect the greater good. No, you're not. Like, kind of thing. It's like, hey, they're actually having like these pretty serious conversations right now. And I was not expecting that. So it's great. I wish that more people were having these conversations about moral subjectivism. I think our world could really use it right now. But moving on to number three. I know in previous videos, I have for sure mentioned that I'm typically not a fan of fiction anything. So I, like, rarely would you ever see me sitting down reading a fiction novel. It's just not my cup of tea. With the exception of extremely historical fiction-oriented books. I think one of the reasons why I even started gravitating toward comic books is because I didn't realize how focused they were on real life stuff. So I always kind of had like a really bad misinterpretation of them where it's like, oh, it's just all this like little sci-fi-y stuff with these weird characters like doing weird shit. But it's not. A lot of it I can actually relate to, and I think a lot of people can relate to comics, which is awesome. But Bombshells is very historical fiction oriented, kind of takes place in a lot of war era zones. So for instance, the first and second are focusing on the time when America had the Japanese internment camps, which like, yikes, current stuff happening in our country. I am fully aware that right now there's a lot of criticism surrounding political involvement in comic book themes. I have a lot of opinions on that. You know, in general, I think that some of the greatest comic books derive from political issues, but that's like, that's for another time. In general, Bombshells does a really, really good job of giving you this very serious event and saying, hey, like, this is mentally, I don't know how to process this. I want to just jump the gun and say this is really bad, but I have people telling me that it's not bad, you know, and then I'm surrounded by other people who are kind of complacent to the idea. Why are people complacent? Should I be complacent? You know, there's a lot of internal dialogue that's happening within these comic books that I think is really important, because I think that in reality a lot of people have their own internal dialogues about these things as well. So yes, incorporating historical fiction into this comic series is really intriguing to me, just because I think a lot of people can, you know, read that and kind of remove themselves from everyday reality, but at the same time be like, wow, like maybe I can critically think about what's going on right now based on what I was just reading about a historical fiction account of what has happened. And that's pretty cool. The fourth point that I wanted to talk about is kind of the philosophy of the human condition. And, you know, like I said, comics have always done a really good job of bridging the gap between what a normal person is and what a superhero is. And sometimes it takes the reader to, you know, I guess critically think about that concept a little bit more, because rarely are they saying you're the same thing. If that makes sense. But internally, you know, a lot of us can take what we're reading and apply it to real life, where it's like, hey, but like, I can still have that superhero mentality. What I really like about these comics is that they involve very normal girls with very not normal superhero females. So, for instance, there's a group of girls who just want to help out for the cause. They're trying to help rebel against the Japanese internment camps, and so they're kind of working alongside Wonder Woman and Hawkgirl and things like that. So they don't necessarily have superpowers, but it's funny because they see these female superheroes going through a lot of internal conflict, and from their perspective, they're kind of like, you're Wonder Woman, like, what's wrong with you? But there, you know, there's valuable lessons to learn in that, though. It's just that, you know, from a human level, humans and superheroes have the same mortal conflicts. I really think that's an important lesson for little boys and little girls, like any kind of little kid to learn from, because whenever that you look up to a spectacular figure such as Wonder Woman or Superman, you know, you kind of feel an internal pressure to obtain that level of perfection, but there never is a level of perfection. And that's something that I've always really admired of comic writers, is that they place very human elements in these superheroes. And that's important because whenever we go through our daily lives, you know, we can remember those things, and we can remember that, like, we're human, we go through shit. Hey, these superheroes even are going through shit. So it kind of compels people to you know, have the courage to take that step forward in whatever aspect of their lives and realize that it's okay to have, you know, emotional and mental qualms about whatever it is that they're doing. And, you know, I know that all of this review has kind of been more on conceptual aspects, but I don't want to give away, you know, like, what actually happens in these. I really hope that you all, like, make an effort to actually read them because they're pretty fantastic. But I just thought it was really interesting that, you know, just from these two books, I picked up on all of those themes. And they're very contextual themes. And what's kind of fascinating is that they're really contextual themes, but these aren't very hard comics to read. So, like, when you're reading them, it's everything is put in very, you know, I would say easy general terms, but the writing is so good that you're still able to conceptualize all of these deeper things that are happening. And that is fantastic comic book writing. And with that, I am concluding this review. I'm super stoked to go pick up the rest of this series. If you guys have any suggestions for me to read, please let me know. I really love hearing your feedback about everything. I'm always down for reading new comics. So I guess that's it. See you later. Wait. Before you go, don't forget to like and subscribe wherever the button is.